Heist 88, released in 2023 on Netflix. This is quite a nerve-wracking adventure.
There'll be no contact on this planet. Board separately and don't speak to each other. I'll page you when we land.
I need to know where $80 million is right now.
Jeremy Horn has an ability to convince anyone to do just about anything.
One last score, 80 million. Help me rob the First National Bank of Chicago. I will make each of you very wealthy.
We are talking about robbing a bank. Where we work!
I'm in trouble. I owe money.
But I'm tired of living like I'm living.
I got a bank, like 330 Bob an hour.
We pull this off, we're gonna be the new kings of Chicago.
We pull this off, we'll never be able to live in Chicago again.
I say we go get this money.
Do you even care about what happens to us?
Get me the FBI.
Then we need to move now.
This is for real.
It's a heart attack.
A criminal mastermind, played by Courtney B. Vance, recruits a group of young black bank employees to steal $80 million from their employer. Now, it's a good thing always when young people are working and working in the blue collar, the white shirted industry of banking and making some money. But it's a whole different thing when they embark upon stealing from that employer, but they're captivated by the wiles of our anti-hero played by Courtney Vance. It's an interesting flick to be released. It's a bit different. Like with all heist films, the script is a thing, and of course, watching the machinations of putting this heist together is always interesting there. But writer Dwayne Johnson Cochran, who also had a hand as a co-star in his own film, and directed by Minaj Huda, do a pretty good job of moving things along, not getting us too caught up in the backstory of our anti-hero played by Courtney Vance. A surprising thing here is that one of the stars in this, a major film and TV star, Keith David, plays one of the old acquaintances of our anti-hero, and is well down on the casting list here, but it's always good to see familiar faces when you look at this film. All the young stars, Bentley Green, Akina Mali, Xavier Clyde, and Precious Way, this should go a long way in enhancing their acting resumes as you go forth. Again, not a whole lot of time is wasted with this. It is rather slow in some instances as the scheme is worked up and put together. It's nerve-wracking because we know our anti-hero has a record, and many people in the Chicago-based flick are looking for him, including the FBI. And of course, it is a question of who is going to be the rat. That's always the thing in heist film, and as we know, there's always a rat to get your way. But it hangs you on all the way to the end where you are left. Yeah, that's the key. Heist 88, released in 2023 on Netflix. Quite a nerve-wracking ride. I give it 9 of 10 stars. Leave the World Behind, released in 2023 on Netflix. This what-if flick will leave you hanging.
What could it mean?
It could be over in a couple of hours.
You know something? I'm sure this will turn out to be a big nothing.
We'll look back on this one day and laugh, I guarantee you.
I think that ship is heading towards us.
Oh. What does that mean?
We shouldn't speculate. Haven't you been picking up on what's going on out there?
I don't want to panic over nothing. I don't think this is nothing. We're in this together until things get back to normal.
There is no going back to normal.
Get in the car!
Whoever's pulling the
restraint. Wants us to finish it.
We're gonna be okay, right?
Yeah.
The stars Julia Roberts, Mahershala Ali, and Ethan Hawke give us a veteran actor's playlist of good films to be in. Leave the World Behind is no different. It's not dystopian. It could be if they do a part two. It is strange because we have two different sides of the fence that meet up at what appears to be an Airbnb out in the country. One nice American family works and lives in Jersey and has to commute all the time, and the kids are getting bored but all active. And then the mom decides, well, let's take a vacation. Let's get away from it all. And as they drive out to this place that has a nice beach and all of that, things begin to fall apart around them, and they don't have any clue as to what is going on. They are visited by the owners of the Airbnb, who decide to come by because theoretically the father, the pops lost something and he has to get it, but it doesn't get any less strange than a visit from your landlords in this case. But things happen, and things begin to happen all around them that this family is simply not aware of. Why? Because the internet is out. Why? Because the cell phones no longer work. Why? Because even a satellite phone won't pick up a satellite signal. Why? Because the animals in the forest near the house are all standing there looking at them, wondering, why are you humans doing nothing, or why aren't you humans doing something about what is to come? And none of the humans know what is happening or what is to come. One of the strangest scenes in this is to watch, I guess, 100 or so Teslas crash into each other on a highway that blocks our family's ability to escape. And of course, there is the big steamship freighter that runs aground at the beach, and everybody just stands there watching in disbelief until it actually does come aground there. This film was carried well by Julia Roberts and Mahershala Ali, and of course Ethan Hawke with great resumes. It's written and directed by Sam Esmail and Ruman Alam. The script is the thing, and it doesn't waste a great deal of our time. It is frustrating to watch our leaders, our lead characters, go through this, but again, it's a what if film. What would you do? How would you adjust to it? And therein lies the conundrum for everybody involved, especially the children. It's worth your time. Leave the World Behind, released in 2023, can be seen, of course, on Netflix. I give it 9 of 10 stars.